Triggering with GPS position. So using the internal GPS built into your Status Mobile or your XS, we can actually, because we know the location of that device as it's going around the track, wherever the case may be located, the latitude and longitude, we can use that as actually a trigger. So let's go to test lab. We're going to kind of focus on some of these triggers. I think I have a section GPS position trigger. My XS is sitting on my desk here, but it's close enough to the window, and I put my GPS sensor up against the window that I think I have a pretty good connection. Let me go to channel setup and see. Yep, I'm green, so I'm seeing satellites. One thing that if you wanted to track with GPS speed, just FYI, you need to go to the measure tab and make sure you check this box. It'll be off by default. Measure GPS data. And our measuring modes track, doing something simple, time, 10 seconds, half second increment. But to set a trigger for this measurement, which means this has to be met before it starts these tracking parameters, hit the more button. And because we've turned on our GPS sync and it's set to measure with GPS, we have these options. So I could choose GPS latitude, for example. I could put level is actually kind of like the location, 146.5, or in this case, 57.29, whatever the case may be. And you choose a slope as well, meaning as you pass that latitude line, are you going higher or lower? Maybe it'll be more clear to you in the example that I have in the PowerPoint. So it's real easy to set up. Let me jump over to PowerPoint. I tried to do this with the video because it's hard to drive this desk down the street. This is somewhere in California where I'm at. I went out here. I just opened up Google Maps and I was like, okay, I'm just a few blocks away from where I'm living. I chose this point here. This is a street that runs north and south, Euclid Avenue, pretty big street actually. There's traffic traveling this way and then traffic traveling this way on it as well. I chose this point as my GPS trick and I used latitude. So I just open Google, click the point, your mouse at that point, and then it'll tell you what the latitude and longitude is right there. Then I started driving down the road after I had did those settings that we saw here. And when I passed this latitude point, it did not trigger because the latitude that I chose is up. And it's actually going down as I come this way. You'll see in the video, just to kind of get that point to you, as I passed the trigger location, this latitude line, it didn't trigger because the slope wasn't in the correct direction for my trigger. So I was able to come down, do a little turnaround, then go back up. And now I am going to be able to trigger because the slope would be in the correct direction. And you'll see that in the video. So I'm going down the road. You can kind of see the orange here. It's waiting for the trigger. It says ready for time or something like that. And I'm going to very quickly here be passing the GPS location. I look back down. It did not trigger because the slope that it's looking for was not met. What I'll do is turn around this little turnaround here. And I'm going to go back up to that latitude line, just checking traffic. We don't want no accidents out here. I'll pull out. And now we're going to be going back towards that trigger location. And once it passes the trigger location, because the slope is correct, it will trigger the measurement coming up on it. Should be any moment. Oh, that sign right there tells me I think it's coming. That orange will turn green once it triggers. There it is. So it triggered based on this GPS location point. And going back to the software, that was used to start it. I could also have set an endpoint just a mile further or whatever. I just didn't do that. But you can trigger your GPS location for starting and stopping the test. Let me hop back to PowerPoint. Triggering with multiple channels. Let's talk about that real quick. So I can set that trigger and I can use one of my dynamic channels. I can use my GPS channels, Taco itself, obviously, but I can only choose one at a time. So maybe that's not super useful all the time. Probably the majority of cases it'll cover, but there are methods for using multiple channels, I guess you could say multiple parameters, to trigger start or trigger stop to your test. And let me show you, if I go back to the PowerPoint. So I already showed you virtual channels. Virtual channels can also be useful for us to trigger a measurement using multiple parameters. So we're using virtual logic, basically, logic commands, greater and smaller. And with this one, basically what is going on, it's not only triggering based off a location, which is this latitude position here, but also speed. So it needs to be greater than 19 kph rate or miles per hour or 21. It has to be in between those two. And using these two and statements, basically I can come up with this virtual channel 5, which will include V1, which is accounting for the location, and V4, which is accounting for the speed, like it needs to be in between these two. And when that virtual logic is true, it's 1, when it's false, it's 0. Using V5 as my channel, setting the level to 1, right, because that's what the logic will give us when those things are true, it will trigger. And I didn't do this live, but you can kind of hopefully see it's rather straightforward as well to be able to use multiple parameters to do your triggering. You just need to use the virtual channels to make use of virtual logic and able to do it.